Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Lone Survivor, The Eyewitness Account of Operation Red Wing, and The Lost Heroes of SEAL Team 10 book by Marcus Luttrell. This book should be read for content, for its honest, intimate narration, for its testimony to courage, character, and the intensity of human experience. His description of his training as a Navy SEAL defines what every male aspires to be. Falling off a mountain by accident is tough enough, but hurling yourself off a steep mountain not just once, but many times, on purpose, to save your life has got to be something you get from getting knocked in the head from your Navy SEAL training. His description of the events are in par with the best action books out there. He does an amazing job of describing the situation, the terrain, the firefights, the injuries, and the heroism of his fallen team. Overall, it is inspirational to know how tough, committed and, yes, heroic our SEALs are. But in the context of this story, that is being the individuals who are the boots on the ground facing a scenario that may as well be walking on the moon for just about anybody else. The discussions about people gathering at his parents' house to provide comfort during his ordeal was an inspiration. And last, the discussion about the Afghan group that risked their own life to save his was a wonderful testament to our involvement over there. Grab a copy of this book if you are interested in the blood, sweat, and tears of a Navy SEAL, and Operation Red Wing in particular. The book itself, as far as a piece of literature is concerned, is a bit choppy. The book opens with Luttrell visiting the homes of the families that lost their loved ones in Operation Red Wing. The book is half over before the read actually gets into the Operation Red Wing itself. But distractions aside, this is a wonderful tale of a young man using multiple resources to overcome devastating circumstances. It is a shame that the author makes the common mistake of confusing political outlook in these United States with love of country. The story is well written, and engaging, and avoids getting bogged down in details the way some Clancy novels are. Everyone's got to have his little hands in it, blathering on about the public's right to know. There are at least 17 comments about this issue, and they are all negatively attacking liberal ideology. And the fact that there are records of the events so the readers won't hear about another untruthful author reliving a heroic event, makes this book even better. This is not a conventional story, and knowing the ending beforehand doesn't detract one iota from the story of Marcus Luttrell's amazing passage through SEAL training, and the events in the mountains of the Hindu Kush. Literary embellishment could do nothing for such a story and, in fact, it would only detract from it. As good as the movie is, the true life account is even more intense and riveting. Plus the lives lost trying to rescue them when one of the helicopters was shot down. To read about what truly happened on that mountain, and the efforts and sacrifices made was incredible. Sadly, some of them had to do just that, based on the decision they had to make. There are several companion books to this one that tell different sides of this story. It is one man's story, his version of the events that led to the death of the other three other SEALs on a mission gone wrong, called Operation Red Wings. However, if you want the story told, but the man who was there, who fought, and survived, then this is it. The main story concerns four Navy Special Forces soldiers who sneak into the Hindu Kush Mountains in northeastern Afghanistan, on a mission to eliminate a leader of terrorists. It deserves to be read not just by patriotic Americans, and fans of military lore, but by any person who deeply values freedoms of speech, press, and religion. Read Marcus Luttrell's story, however, and understand absolutely that these freedoms have champions, a stalwart group of modern knights called SEALs. This first-hand account of a SEAL's journey of courage and personal fortitude is gripping. You can feel the raw emotions as Marcus relates the challenges faced to earn the honor of wearing the trident. A true story of the courage, bravery, and brotherhood of America's finest presented in a well-written and gripping narrative. Great insight into the mindset of these elite warriors, and perhaps the best summary of the training out there. But beyond all the grit, and reality, and incredible action, and even beyond the internal moral framework of the heroic warrior, there is a deeper story here that leaves many questions unanswered, as all great stories do. Marcus ran into two brands of Muslims, those committed to, and risking their lives to take his life, and those committed to, and risking their lives to save him. They were a little cocky, but they also had permanent scars on each knuckle of both hands from learning to attach explosives to underwater objectives during recent training, and stories of surviving long periods of shivering cold. See the movie again, and you'll notice a few things that probably seemed inconsequential the first time around. Plus, like ants, and other low-life insects, Terry's always more Taliban lurking in the shadows than you can see. They were out there trying to make the world a better place, for us, and for the people of Afghanistan. The sense of belonging, of having place, and purpose, of responsibility for more than simply oneself, all of it is described and explained in such a way as to allow anyone to understand. This book is a compelling story of heroism, and four heroes, including the author, who fought a terrible battle in Afghanistan on June 28, 2005. And the training continues on and on after they are a Navy SEAL, and then when they get ready for their missions. This emphasis on training and the challenges of being a Navy SEAL shows that this job is hardly glorious and romantic, but very important to the defense of our country. As the battle progressed, it became obvious why the training is so very tough and rigorous. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.